I would like to offer you a brief overview of Greek Bronze Age in Bulgarian lands. There is no comprehensive synopsis of the period to date. The late Bronze Age chronology and stratigraphy have not yet been well defined as compared to those of the early Bronze Age. It was only in the last few decades that the Middle Bronze Age has been identified in Bulgaria. A transitional period to the early Iron Age was recognized as a number of features and pottery shapes continued into the first millennium BC. In the late second millennium, a change in the settlement pattern occurred. Numerous tells were abandoned, and our archaeological material originates mainly from peak sanctuaries. Seasonal settlements with non-monumental architecture appeared on hills and mountainous slopes, some of which show traces of fortification. Fortified sites up in the mountains would become typical for the Thracian early Iron Age. In this respect, two key sites should be mentioned. One is Agatakwe and Dragoyna, both in the Rhodope Mountains. Seasonal occupation was related either to transhuman economy or to metallurgy. Pottery evidence suggests a revival of the early Bronze Age greyware, termed Anatolian greyware, best observed at Troy. Examples of possible Anatolian imports were detected at the Dragoyna site. As you can see, this, all the sites were possible Anatolian imports occurred. This type of pottery survived into the early Iron Age, becoming Aeolian Bukero in Anatolia. The first millennium BC survivals can be seen at Daskyleion and Gordion. Finds from Bulgaria were previously called Thracian greyware, but now Anatolian influences are well recognized. Imports of metal vessels probably stimulated new shapes and types of greyware in the late Bronze and early Iron Age in Thrace. Anatolian types of late Bronze Age amphora and greyware were attested at Dragoyna. Carinated bowls with two high handles were excavated at the Vratitsa site near Burgas, close to the sea coast. These shapes are known from Troy VI and VIIa. The site yielded vessels with knobs on high handles, also found in Troy VI D to F and Egbe-J Sultan. Most of the material dates to between 1600 and 1400, but some of the finds belong to 13th and 12th century BC. Unfortunately, there are no architectural remains from this site. For Western Anatolia, Mycenaean influence was suggested for the northern part of the Aegean Sea coast, while to the south, Mycenaean presence or colonization preceded by a Minoan occupation was observed. Mycenaean Aegean imported or influenced vessels were found at Koprivlen, southeastern Bulgaria, along the lower Nestos Valley, near a Zlok in the same region, and at Dragoyna site. Thus, communication routes can be traced in southern Bulgarian lands along the Strumon and Nestos valleys, as well as in the Rhodope Mountains. The Aegean contacts were well attested from the 15th century BC onwards. At the end of the Late Bronze Age and the beginning of the Early Iron Age, a reverse direction of influences were detected as handmade knobware appeared at Troy. Greyware of Balkan origin was detected in Troy 7b1. Vessels in the same tradition appeared at Daskyleion and Gordion in the 12th and 11th century BC. In Thrace, this very beginning of the Early Iron Age was termed fluted ware horizon or knobware horizon, depending on which element you wish to focus. This type of pottery is generally accepted to be originating in Dobruja, in northeastern Thracian lands. Thus, while for the Anatolian elements of Thracian Late Bronze Age, influences can be assumed, for the reverse process, a Balkan presence or migrations could be considered, or simply just an archaeological visibility just at that time for unknown reasons. Metallurgy was crucial for the development of Late Bronze Age societies. Recent research revealed Asian exploitation of gold, silver, and copper mines in the Late Bronze Age Thracian lands. Temporary settlements and sanctuaries appeared around such mining centers. Agatepe, near Krumovgrad, southeastern Bulgaria, is some of the best studied sites of prehistoric mining. Rectangular houses with some with stone foundations and water-dope aquastructure dated to the first quarter of the 15th century were excavated. In the 13th century, the upper part of the site was fortified by a stone wall. A sanctuary probably serving the miners living there appeared in the 14th and 13th century. Referring to metallurgy, two case studies will be presented: Late Bronze Age stone and bronze scepters and the coppering gods. Two stray finds of stone mace scepters find good parallels in the find from Luberon shipwreck. The one from Lulin and the other from Glavan. The mace from Luberon has long been interpreted as showing connections with the Balkans. Similar stone maces and bronze examples were found in the Eastern Balkans. The latter suggest metal prototypes of the stone axes. The stone molds for similar bronze scepters from Razgrad, northeastern Bulgaria, supplement the evidence. The concentration of these finds seems to coincide with sites of gold and copper deposits and could be related to metallurgy development. Decorative patterns of the stone and bronze scepters, as you have seen on the previous slides, display Mycenaean affinities. On the other hand, one cannot miss the parallel with the crooked scepter of the Hittite kings. These stone and bronze Mycenaean scepters could have marked the appearance of new elites that owed their prosperity to metal extraction, production, and trade. The picture could be supplemented by the distribution of another type of metal artifacts, coppering gods. Although none of the oxhide gods were found in archaeological contexts, their occurrence is again mainly in the eastern Thracian lands. Some were found in hordes of bronze objects. Others were partially damaged, suggesting that they were associated with metal production. All ox-hiking dogs are comparable in shape, size, weight, and technology of casting with those from the Eastern Mediterranean. In addition, some of them bear signs from Lake Bronze, from different Lake Bronze Age Aegean scripts. Most of their finding spots, however, were located in areas where copper and gold deposit existed and some more exploited in antiquity. These are sites in the Stranja Mountain along the southwestern Black Sea littoral and the eastern Rhodope Mountains. To a great extent, their distribution coincides with finds of the stone and bronze scepters. Although no context information is available for these types of objects, they are suggestive for the possible routes of communication in the Late Bronze Age. They testify not only to maritime routes, but also to those along the river valleys and the lower mountain passes, suggesting a southeast-northwest route. The quest for metal was obvious. The two case studies presented aimed at showing the involvement of Thracian lands in Late Bronze Age Aegean and Eastern Mediterranean communication network, stimulated by the development of the metallurgy. To conclude, Late Bronze Age saw a growth of metallurgy in Thracian lands and the according reorganization of settlements. The search for metal deposits defines most of the maritime and land routes in the Aegean and Eastern Mediterranean. The change in settlement pattern and the gradual transition to the early Iron Age support the idea that Thracians were present there from the mid-second millennium BC onwards. Anatolian affinities and influences are better recognized in early Bronze Age and Middle Bronze Age race, to the extent that some scholars assume Aegean-Anatolian colonization at some sites in southern Bulgaria. Both Western Anatolian and Southeastern trades participated in the East Aegean trade and cultural networking. A few sites in southeastern Bulgaria have recently offered Anatolian parallels. In the late second and early first millennium BC, the interaction seems to have taken a reverse direction. However speechless in ethnic terms the archaeological finds remain, one can still hypothesize on Thracian presence in northwestern Anatolia at that time. Against this background, it is puzzling that linguists are looking even for a Mysian language in the late second millennium Western Anatolia, but do not mention a word for possible occurrence of Thracian there. Further on, better archaeological investigation of inner Western Anatolia would probably shed more light on the ethnic processes in the Balkan-Anatolian region. Thank you.